Guys, welcome to Pen Dentistry. Hope you are doing good. I am Dr. Aishwarya with you for easy learning and better understanding. If you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, please go and subscribe to my channel and learn the dentistry in an easy manner.
Today our topic is gingival enlargement, the increase in the size of the gingiva. The definition of gingival enlargement is increase in the size of gingiva. As you know, there is an enlargement. The name says that there is an enlargement. That means the increase in the size of the gingiva is taking place. The definition is increase in the size of the gingiva. Now we are going to learn about the classification. What are the classification of the gingival enlargement? First one is according to etiology and pathologic change. According to the cause and what changes it takes place, pathologic changes, on the basis of that, the gingival enlargement is classified. The first one is inflammatory enlargement. In inflammatory enlargement, it might be a chronic or acute drug-induced enlargement. The second one is, the third one is systemic disease. If a patient is having a systemic disease and because of that, the enlargement is taking place of the gingiva, the systemic disease enlargement can be of two types, conditional and systemic. In conditional, the conditions occur in during the time of the pregnancy. When the condition of pregnancy is there, at that time gingival enlargement takes place. When there is a puberty, pubertical condition causes the gingival enlargement. When there is a condition that the patient is a deficiency of vitamin C, at that time gingival enlargement takes place. When there is a plasma cells, due to the changes in the plasma cells, there is a gingival enlargement and non-specific conditional enlargement. This is okay. After that, there is a systemic disease. Which kind of disease takes place and due to that gingival enlargement takes place? The first one is leukemia. In leukemia, there is a enlargement in the gingiva, you can see. And the second one is granulomatous. In granulomatous, you can see the gingival enlargement. The fourth one is neoplastic. Neoplastic, in neoplastic, there is a malignancy, whether the malignancy is benign or it is a malignant tumor. At that time, gingival enlargement takes place. And the last one is false enlargement. In false enlargement, there is no cause, any disease takes place, just there is a gingival enlargement. So according to the etiology and pathology, inflammation, inflammatory drug, systemic, neoplastic and false. The second one is according to the location and distribution. In location and distribution, which location is there and how much the gingiva enlargement is distributed. The first one is localized. Localized means gingival enlargement here limited to one or more teeth. One or more teeth, okay, 2, 4, like that. And in generalized, entire mouth, the whole mouth will going to be, the whole mouth enlargement, gingival enlargement will going to take place. Here the gingiva is enlarged, more enlarged. If everything is involved in gingival enlargement, every gingiva, then at that time the whole mouth will going to be enlarged. The third one is marginal. In marginal, the gingival enlargement is limited to the margin level of the gingiva. Okay, and the fourth one is papillary. Papillary is confined to the interdental papilla. The interdental papilla, these are the tooth. The interdental papillas, these, between the two teeth, they get enlarged. So papillary enlargement. Diffuse enlargement is, this is involved all the part of the gingiva, that is marginal, attached and interdental. In diffuse, every attached gingiva as well as the papillary, everything will going to be enlarged, okay, every gingiva. so diffused, and the discrete one is isolated sessile or pedunculated tumor like structure takes place. Pedunculated tumor like means the gingiva will going to form like this and it will going to enlarge. Okay, so this is the discrete one. And the next one is according to the degree. According to the degree, the first one is grade 0. In grade 0, there is no sign of gingival enlargement. That means the person is not having any kind of enlargement in their gingiva in grade 0. And the grade 1, in grade 1, enlargement confined to the interdental papilla. The interdental papilla will going to be involved here. Okay, in grade 3, your enlargement involves papillary and marginal gingiva, papilla as well as the margin of the gingiva. This margin as well as the papilla will going to be involved, will going to enlarge. And in grade 3, enlargement covers the 3/4 or more of the crown. If this is the crown from occlusal view, it is going to cover all the surrounding of the tooth. Everything will going to enlarge around the tooth. 3/4 or more of the crown. This was the gingival enlargement classification. Hope you liked the video and understood well. If you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, so please subscribe to my channel and keep watching Pendentistry. Share this video to your friends and your batchmates for easy learning and better understanding.